This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Lead, eld, is a chemical element with atomic number. In ancient Rome, and lead became easily available to common people after the fall of Rome, levels of lead production fell, and those of Rome were not surpassed anywhere until as late as the Industrial Revolution. The metal was established as poisonous as late as in the late 19th century, which led to its eventual displacement from many uses, and it has been or is being phased out from those which include immediate contact to people. Lead has several properties that make it advantageous to use, alongside its commonness, high density, low melting point, ductility, and relative inertness against oxygen attack. Lead minerals are easier to mine and lead is easier to extract from its ores than many other metals, which makes the resulting metal relatively inexpensive. For example, lead is used in building construction, lead acid batteries, bullets and shot weights, as part of solders, pewters, fusible alloys, and as a radiation shield. Currently, lead is produced in quantities of around 10,000 tons annually. Secondary production from recycling is gaining ground, accounting for around half of that figure. Lead's toxicity has been a reason why lead was or is being phased out for some uses if ingested or inhaled. Lead and its compounds are poisonous to animals and humans. Lead is a neurotoxin which accumulates in soft tissues and bones, damaging the nervous system and causing brain disorders. Excessive lead also causes blood disorders in mammals. Contents. 1. Etymology. 2. Properties. 21. Atomic. 22. Physical. 23. Chemical. 24. Isotopes. 3. Chemistry. 31. Inorganic compounds. 311. Leady. 312. Leadive. 313. Other oxidation states. 32. Organolead. 4. Origin and occurrence. 41. In space. 42. On Earth. 5. History. 6. Production. 61. Primary production. 62. Secondary production. 7. Applications. 71. Elemental forms. 72. Compounds. 8. Biological and environmental effects. 81. Biological. 82. Sources of exposure. 83. Environmental. 84. Restriction of lead usage. 9. See also. 10. Notes. 11. References. 12. Bibliography. 13. Further reading. 14. External links. Etymology. The modern English word lead is of Germanic origin. It comes from the Middle English lead and Old English lead, with the macron above the e signifying that the vowel sound of that letter is long. The Old English word is derived from the hypothetical Proto-Germanic lauda lead. According to the linguistic hypothesis, this word bore descendants in most Germanic languages, with a major exception being German of exactly the same meaning. The origin of the Proto-Germanic lauda is not agreed on in the linguistic community. One hypothesis suggests it is derived from Proto-Indo-European laudh lead, capitalization of the vowel is equivalent to the macron. Another hypothesis suggests it is borrowed from Proto-Celtic loud I. Lead. This word is related to the Latin plumbum, which gave the element its chemical symbol Pb. The origin of loud IO presumably pre-dates the Proto-Indo-European language. While it is yet unknown, it is suggested it is also the origin of Proto-Germanic bliva, which also means lead, from which stemmed the German blei lead. The name of the chemical element is not related to the verb of the same spelling, which is instead derived from eventually Proto-Germanic leidigen to lead. Properties. Atomic. A lead atom has 82 electrons, arranged in an electronic configuration of 4F145D106S26P2. The combined first and second ionization energy of lead, the total energy required to remove the 2 6P electrons from a neutral lead atom, is close to that of tin, its upper neighbor in group 14. This is unusual, since ionization energies generally fall going down a group as an element's electrons become more distant from its nucleus. The similarity is attributable to the lanthanide contraction. This describes the greater than expected decrease in the radii of elements in the lanthanide series from atomic number 57, lanthanum, to 71, lutetium, and causes smaller than otherwise expected ionic radii for the subsequent elements starting with 72, hafnium. It results from poor shielding of the nucleus by the lanthanide 4F electrons. The outer electrons are drawn towards the nucleus, thus resulting in a smaller atomic radius. The combined first four ionization energies of lead exceed those of tin. Contrary to what the periodic trends would predict for this reason, lead, unlike tin, rarely has a 4 oxidation state in inorganic compounds. Such behavior is attributable to relativistic effects, which become particularly prominent at the bottom of the periodic table. The result is that the 6s electrons of lead become reluctant to participate participate in bonding, a phenomenon referred to as the inert pair effect. All the lighter elements in group 14 have a stable or metastable allotrope in which they crystallize in the diamond cubic structure, involving covalent bonds in this structure. Each atom is tetrahedrally coordinated, indicating that all four bonds are equivalent, having each attained the lowest possible energy to explain this, in spite of the fact that two of the electrons are in s orbitals and the other two in higher energy p orbitals. Orbital hybridization is invoked, in which one of the electrons is promoted from an s orbital to a p orbital, and then all form four intermediate hybrid orbitals in a process called sp3 hybridization. The inert pair effect affects the crystal structure of lead, because the promotion energy of a 6s electron becomes larger than the amount of energy that would be released from the additional bonds formed. Thus, rather than having the diamond cubic covalent structure, lead forms metallic bonds, in which only the p electrons are delocalized and shared between the Pb2 ions, resulting in a face-centered cubic structure like those of the similarly sized divalent calcium and strontium. Physical: a sample of lead freshly solidified from molten state. Lead is a bright silvery metal with a very slight shade of blue in a dry atmosphere. It tarnishes on contact with moist air, forming a complex surface mixture of compounds whose color and composition will vary depending on the prevailing conditions. Lead's characteristic properties include high density, softness, malleability, ductility, poor electrical conductivity compared to other metals, high resistance to corrosion conferred by its surface patina, and a propensity to react with organic reagents. Lead's face-centered cubic structure and high atomic weight give it a characteristically high density of 1134. Density exceeds that of common metals such as iron 787, gold 2255. The metal is not attacked by dilute sulfuric acid. The concentrated acid dissolves lead thanks to complexation. Lead reacts slowly with hydrochloric acid. Nitric acid reacts vigorously to form nitrogen oxides and leady nitrate. Organic acids, such as acetic acid, also dissolve lead, but this reaction requires oxygen as well. Isotopes: main article, isotopes of lead. Lead has four stable isotopes, lead-204, lead-206, lead-207, and lead-208. The high number of stable isotopes relies on the fact that lead's atomic number of 82 is even, and is a magic number with its high atomic number. Lead is the second heaviest element that occurs naturally in the form of isotopes regarded as stable. Bismuth has a higher atomic number of 83, but its only primordial isotope was found in 2003 to be very slightly radioactive. The four stable isotopes of lead could theoretically undergo alpha decay to isotopes of mercury with a release of energy, but this has not been observed for any of them. Accordingly, their predicted half-lives are extremely long, ranging up to over 10,100 years. As such, lead is often quoted as the heaviest stable element. Holsinger meteorite, the largest piece of the Canyon Diablo meteorite. Uranium lead dating and lead-lead dating on this meteorite allowed refinement of the age of the Earth to 455 billion plus or minus 70 million years. Three of these isotopes are also found in three of the four major decay chains. Lead-206, lead-207, and lead-208, are the final decay products of uranium-238, uranium-235, and thorium-232, respectively. The decay chains are called the uranium series, actinium series, and thorium series since the amounts of them in nature depend on the presence of other elements. The isotopic composition of natural lead varies between samples. In particular, the relative amount of lead-206 may vary between 2,084% and 2,778%, and the abundance of lead-208 may vary between 524% in normal samples to 90% in thorium ores. For this reason, the atomic weight of lead is given to only one decimal place as time passes. The ratio of lead-206 and lead-207 to lead-204 increase, since the former two are supplemented by radioactive decay of heavier elements and the latter is not. This allows for lead-lead dating analogously. As uranium decays eventually into lead, their relative amounts change. This allows for uranium-lead dating apart from the stable isotopes, which make up almost all lead that exists naturally. There are trace quantities of a few radioactive isotopes. One of them is lead-210, although it has a half-life of 223 years, a period too short to allow any primordial lead-210 to exist. Some small non-primordial quantities of it occur in nature, because lead-210 is found in the uranium series. Thus, even though it constantly decays away, it is constantly regenerated by decay of its parent, polonium-214, which, while also constantly decaying, is also supplied by decay of its parent, and so on, all the way up to original uranium-238, which has been present for billions of years on Earth. Lead-210 is particularly useful for helping to identify ages of samples containing it, which is performed by measuring lead-210 to lead-206 ratios. Both isotopes are present in a single decay chain. Lead-214 is also present in the decay chain of natural uranium-238, lead-212 is present in that of natural thorium-232, and lead-211 is present in that of natural uranium-235. Therefore, traces of all three of these isotopes exist naturally as well. Lastly, very minute traces of lead-209 are also present from the cluster decay of radium-223, one of the daughter products of natural uranium-235. Hence, natural lead consists of not only the four stable isotopes, but also minute traces of another five short-lived radioisotopes. In total, 38 isotopes of lead have been synthesized, with mass numbers of 178-215. Lead-205 is the most stable radioisotope of lead, with a half-life of around 15 × 107. See also, compounds of lead. Lead shows two main oxidation states, 4 and 2. The tetravalent state is common for group 14 TNE. Divalent state is rare for carbon and silicon, minor for germanium, important but not prevailing for tin, and is the more important for lead. Even the strongest oxidizing agents, oxygen and fluorine, initially oxidize lead only to leady. This is caused by relativistic effects, specifically the inert pair effect, which manifests itself when there is a large difference in electronegativity between lead and, for example, oxide, halide, or nitride anions, leading to a significant partial positive charge on lead. The result is a stronger contraction of the lead 6s orbital than is the case for the 6p orbital, making it rather inert in ionic compounds. This is not quite as applicable to compounds in which lead forms covalent bonds to elements of similar electronegativity, such as carbon in organolead compounds. Here the 6s and 6p orbitals remain similarly sized, and sp3 hybridization in compounds is still energetically favorable. As such, lead, like carbon, is predominantly tetravalent in organolead compounds. The 5s electron pair tends to be stereochemically active in tinny compounds, but is much less so in leady compounds. Consequently, there are often structural similarities between leady compounds and analogous compounds of the divalent cations of calcium, strontium, barium, europium, and ytterbium. The electrode potential of lead shows that it is only slightly easier to oxidize than hydrogen. Lead can therefore dissolve in acids, but this is often impossible due to factors such as the formation of insoluble salts. Electronegativity, although often thought to be constant for each element, is a variable property. Lead shows a high electronegativity difference between values for leady and leadive of 187 and 233, respectively. This difference marks a reversal in the trend of increasing stability of the 4 oxidation state down group 14. Tin, by comparison, has electronegativities of 180 and 196 in the 2 and 4 oxidation states. Inorganic compounds. Leady crystalline form of lead sulfate. Lead 2 compounds are characteristic of the inorganic chemistry of lead. Even strong oxidizing agents like fluorine and chlorine react with lead at room temperature to give only lead 2 fluoride and lead 2 chloride. Lead forms binary compounds with many nonmetals, but not all of them. For example, there is no known lead carbide. Most leady compounds are ionic, but they are not as ionic as those of many other metals. In particular, many leady compounds are water insoluble in solution. Leady ions are colorless, but under specific conditions, lead is capable of changing its color. Unlike tinny ions, these do not react as reducing agents in solution. Leady ions partially hydrolyze in aqueous solution to form PbOH, and finally in which the hydroxyl ions act as bridging ligands. Lead monoxide exists in two allotropes, red alpha PbO and yellow beta PbO, the latter being stable only above around 488. Forms a tremendous variety of coordination complexes, such as 2-, 4-, and the chain anion N5N-, although most of them are not yet adequately characterized structurally. Leady sulfate is well known for its insolubility in water, like the sulfates of the other heavy divalent cations. Leady nitrate and leady acetate, in contrast, are very soluble, and this facility is exploited in the synthesis of other lead compounds. Leadive. Few inorganic leadive compounds are known, and they are typically strong oxidants plants or exist only in highly acidic solutions. Leti oxide gives a mixed oxide on further oxidation, Pb3O4. It is described as Leti, IV oxide, or structurally 2PbO-PbO2, and is the best known mixed valence lead compound. Lead dioxide is a strong oxidizing agent, capable of oxidizing hydrochloric acid to chlorine gas. This is because the expected lead 4 chloride that would be produced is unstable and spontaneously decomposes to lead 2 chloride and Cl2, analogously to lead monoxide. Lead dioxide is capable of forming plumbate anions. Lead tetrafluoride, a yellow crystalline powder, is stable, but less stable than the difluoride. Lead tetrachloride, a yellow oil, decomposes at room temperature. Lead tetrabromide is less stable still, and the existence of lead tetraiodide is questionable. Lead disulfide, like the monosulfide, is a semiconductor. Leadive selenide is also known. Other oxidation states see also: plumbide, the capped square antiprismatic anion 4- from 2K2 peta bits 9N15. This is not a simple zintl compound, but rather contains the organic molecules 18 crown 6 and ethylene diamine. And in order to stabilize the crystal structure, some lead compounds exist in formal oxidation states other than 4 or 2. Leti may be obtained as an intermediate between leti and leadive in larger organolead complexes rather than on its own. This oxidation state is not specifically stable, as the leti ion and, consequently, the larger complexes containing it is a radical. The same applies for leiodi, which can also be found in such species. Negative oxidation states can occur as zintl phases, as either free lead anions, for example, in Ba2 peta bits, with lead formally being lead minus IV, or in oxygen-sensitive cluster ions, for example, in a trigonal bipyramidal Pb5-2 ion, where 2 lead atoms are lead minus I and 3 are lead 0. This illustrates lead's proclivity towards catenation, the ability to form chains of atoms of the same element, an ability shared with all the lighter members of group 14 and more generally with most of the heavy p-block elements in such anions. Each atom is at a polyhedral vertex and contributes 2 electrons to each covalent bond along an edge from their sp3 hybrid orbitals, the other 2 being an external lone pair. The shapes of such anions may be determined by Wade's rules. They may be made by reduction of lead by sodium in liquid ammonia. Many mixed leti, IV oxides are known. When lead 4 oxide is heated in air, it becomes at 293 pb-pb bond energy 98. Of organolead compounds find use in chemistry, tetraethylide is produced in larger quantities than any other organometallic compound. Lead tetraacetate is an important laboratory reagent for oxidation in organic chemistry. Other organolead compounds, including homologs of the said compounds, are still less chemically stable. Polyplumbanes are not well characterized and are generally highly thermally unstable and reactive. Lead readily forms an equimolar alloy with sodium metal that reacts with alkyl halides to form organometallic compounds of lead, such as tetraethylide. Plumbane may be obtained in a reaction between metallic lead and atomic not molecular hydrogen atoms of chlorine or bromine displace alkyl groups in tetramethylide and tetraethylide. Hydrogen chloride, a byproduct of the previous reaction, further reacts with the halogenated molecules to complete mineralization, a chemical reaction or a series of reactions transforming an organic compound into an inorganic one of the original compounds, yielding lead dichloride. Origin and occurrence in space chart representing the final part of the S process from mercury to polonium. Red horizontal lines with a circle in their right ends represent neutron captures, right upward blue arrows represent beta decays, left downward green arrows represent alpha decays, right downward cyan arrows represent electron captures. Primordial lead, the isotopes lead-204, lead-206, lead-207, and lead-208, was created by the S process and the R process. The letter S stands for slow or slow neutron capture, and the letter R stands for rapid neutron capture. In the S process, another capture takes a long time, centuries or millennia, while the R process takes only tens of seconds to result in a heavy nuclide of lead's mass. In the S process, a nucleus in a star captures another slow neutron, and if the resulting nucleus is unstable, it typically undergoes a beta decay to become an element of the next atomic number. Lead-204 is created from short-lived thallium-204. On capturing another neutron, it becomes lead-205, which, while unstable, is stable enough to generally last longer than a capture takes. Its half-life is around 15 million years. Further captures result in lead-206, lead-207, and lead-208. On capturing another neutron, lead-208 becomes lead iodide-209, which quickly decays into bismuth-209, which on capturing another neutron becomes bismuth-210, which either undergoes an alpha decay to result in thallium-206, which would beta decay into lead-206, or a beta decay to yield polonium-210, which would inevitably alpha decay into lead-206 as well, and the cycle ends at lead-206, lead-207, lead-208, and bismuth-209 as a result. Relative abundances of the stable lead and bismuth isotopes are multiplied by a cycling factor, which depends on the conditions of the process. Furthermore, lead-208 and bismuth-209 have a very low cross-section towards neutron capture because of their closed neutron shell at neutron number 126. Lead and bismuth are thus very common in stars, in which nucleosynthesis mostly happens through the S process. Apart from the S process, the latter three isotopes have been synthesized as a result of the R process. Lead-204 is not produced in this manner because its isobar mercury-204 is stable, and it is not formed as a decay product of R process products. The R process happens in mediums of great electron density. In such conditions, beta decay is blocked, because the high electron density fills all available free electron states up to a Fermi energy which is greater than the energy of nuclear beta decay, but nuclear capture of those free neutrons can still occur, and it causes neutron enrichment of matter. This results in extremely high density of free neutrons which cannot decay, and, correspondingly, a large neutron flux and high temperatures, which is the reason why neutron capture occurs much faster than beta decay. The R process does not directly form as much lead as the S process, because neutron-rich nuclei with mass numbers 206-208 that would decay to lead are not magic, unlike those that reach the closed neutron shell at neutron number 126 and decay to the platinum group metals around mass number 194. This effect is nevertheless masked, because these lead isotopes are also located at the end of three major decay chains. See above. They are created by the decay of the heavier elements, which are also created by the R process. Most synthesized nuclides with mass numbers just above those of stable lead and bismuth quickly undergo alpha and beta decay to stable lead and bismuth isotopes. Nuclides with mass numbers 232, 235, and 238 and above soon decay to the extremely long-lived isotopes of thorium and uranium, which decay very slowly to lead. These decay away quite slowly and, in some quantities, still exist to this day. Therefore, the amount of lead in the universe is still increasing, although noticeably only in perspective of millions of years. Solar system abundances. Atomic number. Element. Relative amount 42 molybdenum 1046 palladium 03 50 tin 0952 tellurium 1656 barium 1280 mercury 01-82 lead 192 uranium 00052. The isotopes at the end of the chains make up around 9,802% lead in the universe, with non-radiogenic lead-204 making up slightly less than 2%. Lead is not an abundant element in general. Its per particle abundance in the universe is 006 ppb parts per billion. Still, it is an order of magnitude more abundant than mercury, and further exceeds those of most other elements of similar atomic numbers after element 40 zirconium. No element is at least twofold as abundant as lead, and there is no element as abundant as lead starting after element 56 barium. Lead is 3 times as abundant as platinum, 10 times as mercury, and 20 times as gold per mass. Lead's abundance is 10 ppb. The difference between the per mass and per particle abundances is justified by mass difference between lead isotopes and the most common elements. The most common nuclide in the universe, hydrogen 1, has a mass of approximately 1 atomic mass unit, while those of lead isotopes have masses of over 200 atomic mass units. On Earth, lead is a quite common element in the Earth's crust for its high atomic number. Since lead commonly reacts with sulfur, see above, it is classified as a chalcophile using the Goldschmidt classification. Lead is likely to form minerals that do not sink into the core but that stay above on Earth in its crust. Lead's abundance in the Earth's crust is 16 ppm. This results in a great availability of lead minerals and easy extraction of the metal. For this reason, the mineral form of its sulfide, galena, has been known for millennia, as was the metal itself. See below. Lead's pronounced chalcophilic character is close to those of zinc and Copper, as such, it is usually found in ore and extracted together with these metals. Metallic lead does occur in nature, but it is rare as a result of lead's chemistry. It occurs in primary minerals exclusively as leady, unlike tin, which always occurs as tinnive. Lead deposits can be hydrothermal vein, impregnation, and replacement deposits, volcanogenic sedimentary deposits, and hydrothermal or marine sedimentary deposits. World resources of lead exceed 2 billion tons. Massive resources are located in Australia, China, Ireland, Mexico, Peru, Portugal, Russia, and the United States. World reserves, resources ready to be mined for which that would be economically feasible, totaled 89 million tons in 2015, of which Australia had 35 million, China had 158 million, and Russia had 92 million. The main lead mineral is galena. PbS galena is mostly found with other minerals, mostly zinc ores. Most other lead minerals are normally related to galena in some way, for example, Boulanger PB5SB4S11, is a mixed sulfide derived from galena. Anglesite, PbSO4, is a product of galena oxidation. Cerussite or white lead ore, PbCO3, is a decomposition product of galena. Zinc, copper, arsenic, tin, antimony, silver, gold, and bismuth are common impurities in lead minerals. Typical background concentrations of lead do not exceed 0.1. Amulets, for the Indus Valley Civilization and the Mesoamericans. Peoples of Eastern and Southern Africa are known to exercise wire-drawing lead Roman pipes inscribed IMPVEISPVIIITIMPVICOSCNIULIOAGRICOLALEGAUGPRPR. As silver was extensively used as a decoration material and a means for exchange, lead deposits were first worked in Asia Minor in 3000 BCE. Lead deposits were worked in 2000 BCE in the Iberian Peninsula by the Phoenicians, and also in Athens, Carthage, and Sicily with the development of mining and its territorial expansion in Europe and across the Mediterranean. Rome became the greatest producer of lead during the Classical era, with an estimated annual output equaling 80,000 tons at its peak. The Romans obtained lead mostly as a byproduct of extensive silver smelting. Lead mining occurred in Central Europe, Britain, the Balkans, Greece, Anatolia, and Hispania, which alone accounted for 40% of world production. Lead was used for making water pipes, as lead was formable and resistant to corrosion, in the Roman Empire, and, consequently, the Latin word for the metal, plumbum, was the origin of the English word plumbing and its derivatives. Even though some Romans, such as Vitruvius, were able to recognize its danger for health, some researchers suggest lead poisoning was one of the reasons behind the fall of Rome. Lead poisoning, a condition in which one becomes dark and cynical, was called Saturnine, after the ghoulish god of Saturn. The metal was also considered the father of all metals. It was easily available in the Roman society, and as such, its social status was low during the ancient and classical eras, and even far beyond them. Until the 17th century, tin was often not distinguished from lead or seen as a different kind of the metal that lead is. Romans called lead plumbum nigrum, literally, black lead, while tin was called plumbum candidum, literally, bright lead. Their association through history can also be seen in other languages. The word olovo in Czech translates to lead, but in Russian the cognate olovo olovo means tin. In addition to that, lead also bore a close relation to antimony. Both elements commonly occur as sulfides, galena and stibnite. Often together, Pliny declared stibnite would give lead on heating, whereas the mineral on heating actually produces antimony. The originally South Asian surma, galena in English, spread across Asia with that meaning, and also gave its name to antimony in a number of Central Asian languages, as well as Russian. Elizabeth I of England was one European monarch commonly depicted with a whitened face. Lead in face whitened is thought to be one reason behind her death. Lead plumbing in Western Europe may have been continued beyond the fall of the Western Roman Empire into the medieval era, but lead mining in Europe in general fell into decline, with the only region with noticeable production being the Arabian Iberia, and the largest lead production was conducted in South and East Asia, especially China and India, where lead output underwent a strong growth. In Europe, lead production only began to revive in the 11th and 12th centuries, and lead was again used for roofing and piping. From the 13th century, it was used to create stained glass. During the period, lead was used increasingly for wine adulteration. This practice was declared forbidden in 1498 by a papal bull, but it continued long past the date, being a reason of various mass poisonings up to late 18th century. In the wake of the Renaissance, the printing press was invented, and lead served as a key material for its parts, starting with the Johannes Gutenberg's press. Lead dust was commonly inhaled by operators, causing lead poisoning. Additionally, firearms were invented approximately at the same time, and lead, despite its expense over iron, became a chief material for making bullets, because it made less damage to iron gun barrels, had a higher density which allowed for better retention of velocity and energy, and its lower melting point made production much easier. Bullets could be made on wooden fire. Lead was extensively used in cosmetics at the time in Western Europe by the aristocracy, as whitened faces were seen as a sign of modesty. The practice eventually expanded to white wigs and eyeliners, and it only faded out with the French Revolution in the late 18th century. One effect of such prolonged contacts with lead was teeth rotting, and teeth replacements often were also made of lead, which temporarily gave sweet breath, inducing further damage to the organism. A similar fashion appeared in Japan in the 18th century with the emergence of the geishas, with the practice continuing long into the 20th century and the whiteface becoming a symbol of a Japanese woman. Lead was commonly used as a face whitener in the New World. Lead was first produced soon after the European settlers had arrived. The earliest recorded lead production dates to 1621, in the colony of Virginia that had been founded 14 years earlier in Australia. Mining was introduced by the colonists as well, and they opened the first mine on the continent, a lead mine, in 1841, centuries before the Europeans were able to start the colonization of Africa. In the late 19th century, lead mining was known in the Benue Trough and the Lower Congo Basin, where lead was used for trade with the Europeans and as a currency. Lead mining in the Upper Mississippi River region in the United States in 1865. In the second half of the 18th century, Britain and later continental Europe and then the United States entered the Industrial Revolution. During the period, lead mining proved important. The Industrial Revolution was the first time to have greater lead production rates than those of Rome. Britain was the leading producer during the period, losing the status of the greatest producer by the mid-19th century with depletion of its mines and development of lead mining in Germany, Spain, and the United States. Lead production in the United States dominated by 1900. Other non-European nations, in particular, Canada, Mexico, and Australia, started their massive lead production, and by 1900, Europe's output of lead fell below that elsewhere. A great share of demand of lead came from plumbing and painting. Lead paints had been invented and regularly used. With invention of gasoline in the late 19th century, lead was extensively used as an additive at this time. More people, the working class, contacted the metal, and this led to the increase of the numbers of those poisoned by lead. This also led to research of effects of lead intake. Lead was proven to be more dangerous in its fume form than as a solid metal. Lead poisoning and gout were linked. Alfred Baring Gerard noted a third of his gout patients was plumbers and painters. Effects of chronic ingestion of lead, including mental disorders, were all studied in the 19th century. The first political acts to decrease the degree of lead poisoning in factories followed in the 1870s and 1880s in the United Kingdom. Promotional poster for Dutch Boy lead paint, United States, 1912. Further evidence of the threat lead posed to human organisms were revealed in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Mechanisms of the harm were better realized, and lead blindness was documented, and countries in Europe and the United States started efforts to reduce the amount of lead a regular person contacts with. The last major innovation to impose contact with lead on humans was adding tetraethylide to gasoline, invented in the United States in 1921. It was phased out in the U.S. and the European Union by 2000. Most European countries banned usage of lead paint for interiors by 1930. The result of many regulations and bans put on lead products was significant. In the last quarter of the 20th century, percentage of people with excessive lead blood levels dropped from over 3/4 of the population to slightly over 2% in the U.S. by the end of the 20th century. The main good made of lead was the lead acid battery, which possesses no direct threat to humans. This allowed for a consistent lead production in the industrialized countries from 1960 to 1990. Lead output in the Western Bloc grew by 31%. The share of the world's lead production of the Eastern Bloc increased from 10% and 30% from 1950 to 1990, with the Soviet Union being world's largest producer during the mid and late 1970s and the 1980s, and China started a massive lead production in the late 20th century. Unlike the European communist countries, China was largely unindustrialized by mid 20th century. In 2004, China surpassed Australia as the largest producer of lead. Similarly to European industrialization, lead has a negative effect on health in the country. Production historical evolution of the production of lead, as extracted impacted in different countries. Production and consumption of lead is increasing worldwide. Lead production generally is divided into two major categories, primary and secondary. The primary production is the production from concentrate from the previously mined ores, and the secondary production is the production from scrap. In 2013, 474. Were China, Australia, Russia, India, Bolivia, Sweden, North Korea, South Africa, Poland, and Ireland. The top lead producing countries were China, United States, India, South Korea, Germany, Mexico, United Kingdom, Canada, Japan, and Australia. According to the International Resource Panel's Metal Stocks in Society report of 2010, the global per capita stock of lead in use in society is 8. Concentrate is the initial quantitative metric of mined lead sulfide. Concentrate is more common for subsequent lead production than oxide concentrate. It commonly has a lead content fraction of 50% to 60%, occasionally varying to up to 30% or 80%. World's largest mining countries of lead, 2015 country output 1,000 tons. Intermediate compound involved. Another promising alternative involves hydrometallurgical means. It is based on anodes of impure lead and cathodes of pure lead dissolved in an electrolyte. Impurities in the resulting metal are still significant. These are mostly contaminants of arsenic, antimony, bismuth, zinc, copper, silver, and gold. The melt is treated in a reverberatory furnace with air, steam, and sulfur, which oxidizes the contaminants except silver, gold, and bismuth. The oxidized contaminants are removed by drossing, where they flow to the top and are skimmed off. Since lead ores contain significant concentrations of silver, the smelted metal also is commonly contaminated with silver. Metallic silver as well as gold is removed and recovered economically by means of the Parkes process, in which zinc is added to lead and adsorbs silver, which dissolves in zinc many times more actively than in lead. Desilvered lead is freed of bismuth according to the Betterton-Kroll process by treating it with metallic calcium and magnesium, which forms a bismuth dross that can be skimmed off. Very pure lead can be obtained by processing smelted lead electrolytically by means of the Betts process. The process uses anodes of impure lead and cathodes of pure lead in an electrolyte of silica fluoride. Once electrical potential is applied, impure lead at the anode dissolves and then plates out in the cathode, while the impurities remain in the solution. Secondary production. Smelting, an essential part of the primary production, is often skipped in the secondary production. The reason for that is that scrap lead itself is commonly reproduced to its metallic form. As such, smelting is only performed when metallic lead had undergone significant chemical transformation, such as oxidation, rusting. When smelting is performed, it is performed in a fashion similar to that of the primary production, in either a blast furnace or a rotary furnace, though both, with the essential difference being the greater variability of what could be extracted as the final product after the latter. The Assasmempt process is a more recent method that possesses a possibility of extension to the primary production. The essence of this process is that the input battery paste is deprived of its sulfur content by, for example, treating it with alkalis and then treated in a coal-fueled furnace in presence of oxygen, which eventually yields impure lead, with antimony being the most common impurity. Refining of secondary lead is similar to that of primary lead. Some refining processes may be skipped depending on the material recycled and its potential contamination, with bismuth and silver being skipped especially often. Of all major impurities of the sources of lead for recycling, lead acid batteries is the most important one. Lead pipe, sheet, and cable sheathing are also significant sources applications.